God, Creator, Redeemer, and sanctify us. Amen.
Amen.
Well, this is fun. Not really, but earlier this year, I received a phone call from a former parishioner, Barbara, and she said, in the midst of the pandemic, she was diagnosed with ovarian cancer. And she had previously asked me to celebrate her funeral. And she said, well, I'm still holding you to that. And I said, okay, Barbara, I'll do that, but can I come and see you while you're alive? She said, oh, I would love that. And so I visited. She was very orderly, getting everything organized. And her children were there, her grown children, and she said, I have a philosophical question for you. And I said, what? She says, well, what happens after death? Like, what happens to after the ashes are gone? And I said, we don't know. But I can tell you, I've been close to death enough time to know something happens. We don't get to see on that other side until we do. So Barbara went back to the hospital, and I went and said prayers with her. And she asked me, I told her I was interviewing her to be with you all, and she said, April 28th. And I said, Barbara, I got the job. And she said, oh, that makes me so happy. And we said prayers, and I left. And she lost consciousness that night. Her body lasted a few more days. And at the funeral, her husband was telling me, there was this bird on the window. There's this bird on the window. It's like, I've been to that hospital hundreds of times. There's no birds hanging out of the windows. He said, no, there was. And it's a swamp bird. And it was a great green heron. Didn't know. And as he's telling the story, I look down, and on his foot is a baby bird, a fledgling, hopping around. And I said, well, there's some messages in here. God's messages come through when we least expect them. Dick went on to make up a country western song about a bird on his foot at his wife's funeral reception. And we hear in our gospel lesson today, who do you say that I am? Who do they say that I am? Who do you say that I am? Some say John the Baptist. Some say Elijah, prophet. And Peter says, you are the Messiah. Peter's idea of Messiah was in the royal lineage from David, back with fallible King David. And Jesus says, you're correct, but not the Messiah you're expecting. The Son of Man must undergo great suffering, die, and after 3 days rise. And Peter says something so rude to Jesus. Quiet. Close your mouth. Shut it. And we get this very human experience of Jesus, who sees that temptation. Who sees that temptation of comfort. Walking his days quietly and calmly. And he says, get behind me. Get behind me. And it's so interesting to think about those things that distract us or become maybe obsessions or interests, but maybe take our eyes off of God, just like everyday life. But how can we put God in front of us? Same behind, but how do we practice God in front of us? Singing, dancing, saying grace at meals. We have a new labyrinth that will be opened up next weekend. Gathering in community. This congregation has gathered both in person and by the internet for the last year and a half. And is now again putting God in front of us. In this time of newness and familiarity, temptation. Jesus says there is suffering, but also there is light. There will be an empty tomb. God's love pervades all that distracts. And it is up to us to help each other to look for those moments. Where is God in this? Where is God in this day, in this moment? Where is God in this congregation? Look around. Like, really look around. God in front of us. God is sharing the peace of God. God in hamburgers and barbecue food and celebration. God doesn't promise us the easy life. He promises God's love to abide.